Good day, everyone! I'm Reynalyn Cabral and I'm here to discuss about work analysis. Work analysis is related to job analysis, but it is more broader in scope in contrast to job analysis. Work analysis involves looking at several or many jobs at the same time. And also, it encompasses about the understanding of what are the important tasks of the jobs are, how they are performed, and what individuals' qualities or features are required to perform it successfully. As I said earlier, work analysis and job analysis are related to each other. They are both detailed and systematic, but of course, on the other side, the outcome is different. To determine the appropriateness of an individual, if he or she is suitable, or if his or her qualities are acceptable, work analysis may involve in a systematic examination and assessment for a job in an entire enterprise, in a specific department, or even in a section or in a unit within a department. There is a general purpose of work analysis, and this is to advise the enterprise managers on how they can enhance the overall performance of their enterprises. And this comprises such as identifying the work that is not being done at all or being done slowly. After the general purpose, there are two more specific purposes of job analysis. To be able to solve the performance problems, work analysis is encouraging the enterprise to create one or more jobs that could be done by people with disabilities. And the second is, work analysis is used as an opportunity to identify opportunities for work experience in enterprises for persons with disabilities. Next topic are the steps in work analysis. To be able to do work analysis, you are required to know the procedures that you will be needing. First, you may start with a general idea of the enterprise by observing what is going on. By doing this, you are trying to find suitable jobs for people with disabilities. But for you to do this, you need to know how the enterprise runs in general, and here are some examples includes what processes are involved, what are the products and services are produced, what is the general working environment, and if there any individuals with disabilities are being employed. Next is identify. In this case, you need to recognize particular departments if there are some opportunities for people with disabilities. And you need to have a good knowledge concerning the different kinds of disabilities, but you don't need to have an individual who has disabilities in their mind. Observe the general work that is happening in the identified department and take a look if the work is flowing smoothly or is there any workers who are under pressure, any sign of bottlenecks, and also if the workplace is clean and tidy. And observe the performance of individual jobs and if it's appropriate in the job description. You are required to identify the gaps between acceptable and the actual performance levels, and if there are any gaps, try to identify the causes. You need to talk to workers and try to ask about their jobs if there are some difficulties and troubles in attaining the required standards. Discuss your observation and your tentative conclusions with the management and talk about the probability of creating some additional jobs and then prepare a proposal. In your proposal, you must include the general description of the jobs to be created, such as its essential features. Lastly, indicate the profile in a broadly manner of people with disabilities you believe could manage these jobs. And that is the end of my discussion. Thank you.
Hi. Hi, I'm Erich Campuzano, and I'm going to discuss about the job design and how it works. So first, let me define what is job design. Job design is the process of creating a job that enables the organization to achieve its goals while motivating and rewarding the employees, which means that the aim of job design is to organize the tasks, duties, and responsibilities that is associated to a certain job to achieve the organizational and individual objectives that increase the employees' access, comfort, and flexibility that are likely to influence the motivation and productivity positively. In short, creating a well-designed job can lead to higher productivity, higher job satisfaction, lower absenteeism, and lower employee turnover, which benefit the organization as well as the employees. And to properly redesign jobs, we need the framework that guides the redesign process. And the best-known framework is Hackman's and Oldham's job characteristic theory, which study how particular job characteristics affect job outcomes, including job satisfaction. According to Hackman and Oldham, there are 5 core job characteristics. First is skill variety. Skill variety is the degree to which a job requires a broad array of skills, which means that the individual is required to have a variety of talents and skills in a job where they can feel challenged and competent so that they will experience a greater chance of experiencing meaningfulness in their job. Second is task identity. Task identity is the degree to which an individual performs a whole piece of work. This is important because the workers will find more meaning in their jobs when they can identify a complete and visible outcome at the end of the day. Third is task significance. Task significance is the degree to which the work impacts others, which means that the work is significant if it can affect other people's lives. And it should not be just the people who are inside the organization, but even those who are outside, because the job will have more meaning if it can help other people to improve their well-being. And knowing that their job has and their performance has a positive impact on others, it will motivate them further to do better. Fourth is autonomy. It is the level of independence and freedom an individual has. This pertains to the degree to which the job provides substantial freedom, independence, and discretion to the individual in scheduling the work and in determining the procedure to be used in carrying out. And last is feedback. Feedback is the information that the workers receive about the effectiveness of their work. This helps the workers to boost their self-esteem because if they are told by their supervisors that they are doing a great job, they are likely to feel motivated to continue with how they are doing. And if they are told that they are not performing as expected, they will respond accordingly and improve their performance. When a job has those 5 characteristics, it will affect 3 critical psychological states of the workers doing the job. First is they will experience the meaningfulness of the work. It is connected to the first 3 core job characteristics. A worker will be able to find more meaning in his job if skill variety, task identity, and task significance are present. Next is they will experience the responsibility of the outcomes of the work. This is where the individual will use the freedom of action to make decisions on how to perform the job, such as making changes in the process, scheduling, and applying certain principles that he deems appropriate and beneficial to the accomplishment of the task. And last is, the employee will have more knowledge of the work result. It will ensure that the worker is fully aware of the success or failure of his work, and in the process, allow them to learn from their mistakes. And this leads to higher productivity, higher job satisfaction, lower absenteeism, and turnover.
After knowing the meaning of job design and how it works, let us proceed to the 4 strategies of job design. So there are 4 strategies that are done in job design. These are job enlargement, job enrichment, job rotation, and re-engineering. So let us start from job enlargement and job enrichment. These two have similarity as they both add tasks on the employees for the sake of being motivated and not being bored. But as they have similarity, there is also notable difference on what they consider on tasks or tasks that are going to be added. On job enlargement, it will add tasks only on the same level of what you are doing. So basically, the tasks that you are going to do are not as difficult as other jobs and also inclined in the job that you applied for. A good example for this is a situation in the US wherein major hospital implemented that robots are going to do surgeries controlled by a surgeon through a console. But later on, they found out that not having a surgeon in the operating table makes the communication a blur. And as a result, the assistants, which are people, will be trained in communication with the team, as well as the execution of a variety of activities done by a surgeon. The training that will be done will be a motivator towards the assistant as they are surely finished with the degree and what they are doing is inclined in what the surgeon is practicing. Advantages on job enlargement includes creates a wider range of activities as it gives various tasks or responsibilities to the employees. It results in them having knowledge on other things, making them capable of doing other jobs related to the level of their work. Reduces monotony. As it creates wider range of activities, it decreases monotony as employees do not always do the same. Teaches a variety of skills in helping their career growth. Due to the tasks that are added, the employees learn more about various jobs and making them qualified, thus the career path that they are going through is not narrow. Earn a higher wage. It just means that more jobs to the employees means more compensation to them. Gives more autonomy, accountability, and responsibility. Because the person is now responsible for multiple related activities, the person has now more freedom over how they do their work, leading to more autonomy. But as they are given more autonomy on how to do things, the more accountable and responsible they are on the tasks that they are going to do. As for job enrichment, it also adds tasks, but it has dimension and will not just limit on what you applied as an employee. A good example for this is when a secretary of an organization or a company is given a task to also welcome guests or visitors. So if you ask where is the dimension there, it is on the part where the secretary will also welcome guests. How does that become a dimension? It is not usually required in the job of a secretary, but it's the same purpose of job enlargement, which is to add motivation and for the employees not to be bored. Talking to people as they welcome guests will be a motivator and will surely reduce the boredom that they feel. As for the advantage of job enrichment if it is done, it is categorized more on the psychological state, personal and work. For the psychological state, it is more of finding meaning in work, having motivation and tasks that are given, thus having impact on work. As for work, motivation is a result, as well as high quality performance, higher work satisfaction, better work experience, and lower absence and employee turnover. Job rotation is the process of transferring one employee to another. It is not just a simple transfer like just appointing someone to another job without considering the requirements. It is usually only on the same levels of what an employee applied. It is only for the meantime as he will return to their original job eventually. It does not mean that someone will be promoted, but it is just simply transferring an employee on another job or department for competencies. An example for this one will be the nurses. When it comes to rotation, shift is not the only thing that is happening on nurses, but also the job. Job rotation on nursing are them being transferred on other departments or branches of the hospital, and that's just being that. On different jobs or practices. Flexibility. Rotation allow employees to do different jobs, leading to more flexible workforce. Employee replacement. When a critical employee suddenly leaves, the role have to be replaced by someone in the company. Orientation and placement. An area where the rotation is often applied in internships. It is a process which helps the company on where does a certain trainee must be suitable for. Satisfaction and attrition. When someone is stuck in a job for 4 to 5 years, they may be a high risk of leaving. Job rotation offers opportunity for a change of scenery and challenge people, leading into increased satisfaction and lower employee attrition. Global talent management. It is a strategic endeavor to optimize the use of human capital. We know that companies invest on the trainings of employees, and for them, it is a must to maximize the capability of a worker, not only for the employee, but as well as the company. The more competent an employee is, the more the company will receive as it is the result of high work performance.